So we're asking the question of how nerve cells in the brain connect to each other to transmit information in a way that then later helps the brain to actually do something. For example, when we see something and interpret what's happening in the world. And in particular, we are interested in a phenomenon that has been observed some time ago already. That is that the brain is active already before we are born, for example, before we get any information from the outside world. For example, babies open their eyes pretty much immediately after birth, and it seems as if they can recognize faces without any learning processes. So they have some concept of a face when they're born. And so this is somehow pre-wired in our brains, and it's completely unclear how this is possible. And we also know that in babies that probably have autism, certain activity patterns are also different than in healthy babies. And so we think that this wiring of the brain, the connection between nerve cells that is regulated by certain patterns of spontaneous activity is important for these processes. And if we can understand how it works, we may find ways of fixing it early on. So we use mice as our model organism, as we say. And one aspect of the development of mice is that they are blind when they are born. They open their eyes only 2 weeks after birth. That means what's happening in babies just before birth is happening after birth in mice. And that helps us to do these experiments. It's much easier, of course. And look at what the patterns are and try to find out how these patterns of activity help neurons and nerve cells to connect each other. Yeah, so the brain is really everything that determines our character, how we behave and interact and how we perceive the world. Of course, one could also say the brain is kind of a computer. Yeah, and it has different strengths than the Mac or Windows PC. No personal preferences there. But you can still see, I mean, what computers can do is pretty amazing, but there's so many things that computers still can't do that the brain can do easily.